Are any of your core memories tainted by envy? It's okay to admit it. You've probably eyed someone's summer vacation highlights on Instagram, or wished for that delicious-looking dish on the table next to you at dinner. Sure, emotions like envy are a bit more complicated than a few cartoon characters running amok at headquarters in the brain, but is envy actually such a bad thing? I'm a psychology professor who studies human emotions, particularly envy. With Inside Out 2 hitting the big screen with a cast of new angsty teenage emotions, let's do a deep dive into one of them, envy. Envy is that unpleasant feeling you can get when you compare yourself to someone who you find superior in some way. Envy feels bad because it makes you feel inferior, inadequate, or resentful.
These girls are so cool!
We can't let her know we're excited.
While this may sound negative, there's no such thing as an emotion that's never useful. Emotions are just reactions fine-tuned over millions of years of evolution to promote our survival and to push us closer to our goals. That means all emotions can be useful under the right conditions.
Just don't look down and keep moving.
When you experience envy, you're paying attention to what you perceive to be an important part of your life in which you're falling behind. Maybe you see a classmate doing better than you, and you realize that you need to get your grades up. Or maybe you witness a coworker get a promotion, so you redouble your efforts to get ahead next time. Whatever the trigger is, envy hyper-focuses your attention so you can pull yourself back up. That doesn't mean envy's always nice. Most of the time we experience a benign envy that makes us feel unhappy, longing for something that another person has.
I'm envy!
Oh, look at your hair.
Oh yeah, not happening.
But envy can also be destructive when it creates resentment or ill will toward others. This is what we call malicious envy. If you're finding yourself struggling with envy, here are a few tips to keep envy from hogging the controls of your brain. Number one, don't beat yourself up. Use envy as information about what you value and as motivation to push harder to achieve it. Second, recognize that you have the power to change your circumstances. Don't lament that the world is unfair or assume that someone else cheated to get what they have. And third, remember that not everything in life is a competition. Just because someone has something you want doesn't mean you can't have it too. In the first Inside Out movie, the character Joy discovers how important sadness can be for Riley. We may do well to level up our own emotional intelligence and recognize the important role envy can play in our own lives. It might just make your next core memory a special one.
Say what you want. I think it's all beautiful.